Now let's consider how we would handle a volume integral in cylindrical coordinates. Let's say that I have a charge density of 4 coulombs per meter cubed, and I wanted to know the total charge inside this region. Then what I would do is a triple integral, where I would put my function 4 coulombs per meter cubed, and then I would put my dV term, which is r dr d phi dz. And I would integrate this over the specific range. R would go from 0 to 1. See right here is my radius, 0 to 1. Phi would go from phi equals 0 to phi equals pi by 4. And my z term would go from this value right there, which is 2, to this value, which is 5. And I would do this integral. Notice that the r, when we integrate that, we're going to get r squared over 2 from 0 to 1. Phi is just going to be phi from 0 to 4, and z will be z from 2 to 5. Now, what would have happened if instead of having a constant value, I had had 4 that was changing with r, which means the current density or the charge density was much stronger out here on the outside of my little cylinder than it was on the inside. In that case, I would simply have put the r in here, and when I integrated, I would have gotten cubed over 3, and that would have just changed the numbers that I received somewhat. The process would still always be the same. What are the things that I did? I found my function. I simply plugged it in with my dv value. There's the dv term. Then I figured out what my limits were, plugged it all in, integrated it, and came up with a value for the total volume that I was interested in.